All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Dan Blondal. He is the CEO of Nano One Materials Corp. And Dan, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Always good to see you, Steve. Best of the holidays to you.
Yeah, best of the holidays to you as well. And it's a pretty exciting end of the year for yourself and Nano One. Let's take a step back here, because I know that back in, I guess it was September, October, you had talked about the ability to scale up the operations of the new plant in Candiac. And you're at this point now where you're going to be doing that. So let's take you back a little bit and talk to everyone about the plant and what you were trying to do there first.
Yeah, maybe just a reminder to everyone, we acquired this plant from Johnson Matthey. We took a hold of it in November last year, so a year ago, and then we undertook to decommission all the waste handling and water handling equipment that we don't need because we don't have any effluent in our process, and then really started doing evaluations in the existing reactors and started installing some new smaller reactors all in the spirit of bringing it back as a pilot plant so that we could make materials, we could demonstrate the technology to our prospective partners and customers. And back in September, we gave a progress update on that. We looked like everything was on schedule, largely on budget. And really, this update that we came out with this morning is very much that we've hit those targets. We are shipping materials right now at the ton scale out to automotive partners and a whole bunch of other people in the energy storage space. This would be for renewable energy storage for wind and solar, the defense industry, who are also looking for battery materials. So that's kind of the gist of the news release today, and I'm excited to be here talking about it.
Yeah, Dan, a month ago you were shipping much smaller scale, and now you're in the tons. I mean, that's over a month. That's a pretty impressive feat by the company to be able to do that.
Yeah, look. If we look back to why we acquired the facility in Candiac, it was largely we saw an opportunity here to use an existing plant with existing equipment and a tremendous amount of know-how and horsepower there to accelerate our activities. So what our shareholders, what our stakeholders have seen us do is move from kilograms to tons in a matter of a year. And that's largely on the back of the know-how, the equipment, and of course the trust and of our partners in moving this thing forward as quick as we can.
Dan, just so everyone understands processes, you mentioned that you're shipping that material out now to prospective customers, and so they will take it and do what with it, and what do you hope to have the final outcome from those tests for these companies?
It's a great question, and maybe it makes sense to step back a little bit. When you initially start with a customer or a potential customer, it will literally start at the gram level, maybe 100 grams of material for someone who might do some very initial tests, and if that's successful, it'll move to kilogram level tests. Ultimately, the big producers of batteries, the automotive companies or the big energy storage companies need kilograms to run in their very smallest the test platforms. But really, for full-scale batteries, they need tons of material to be able to make batteries, test out the electrochemical properties of that material. So they'll coat it under foils, they'll combine it with all the other components that go into a cell, they'll make a full-size cell, and they will evaluate that in a series of tests. Electrochemical tests, basically subject to fast charging, slow charging. They'll subject it to different voltage ranges and such, and that really enables them to understand what the performance properties of the material are. There's always improvements to be made, and there's always you work with your customers to kind of say, okay, well, you know what, it passes all your check marks, but we can improve it in this area in the future. And so building that confidence level is super important. And that's obviously that's the know-how we have in the team, but also the ability to make LFP materials in full-size equipment today completely de-risks it for them. What a lot of people don't realize is that when you scale up a chemical process from a beaker to a vat to a reactor and then something that's fully industrial size, that's when things really go sideways. And so being able to demonstrate these materials being made in full-size reactors that will be used in a full-scale plant really fundamentally de-risks it for prospective buyers or licensors of the technology.
Absolutely. Let's talk about 2024. What's the key to next year? Is it sales? Is it contracts? Is it deals? It's or all the above?
There'll be, look, it's really all of the above. Look, we've got a pilot plant. It's going to be, it's operated in a kind of campaign mode to address the needs of various sort of testing programs. Some of those materials will be sold, but it's largely cost recovery. We don't kind of consider it kind of, you know, whole scale revenue. But what we're really trying to do in 2024 is get over that, get over the hurdle towards a long-term order. And this would be offtake for the materials in the future in a larger plant. That offtake will then drive the expansion plans we have to build those larger plants to feed that. It'll drive the licensing strategies we have and the licensing discussions we're having with other players who might be able to fulfill that that offtake as well through the licensing, construction, and operation of a plant from Nano One. So those are really key. Putting the partnerships in place to do all that obviously are important, whether they be the you know, joint ventures to operate a plant in Quebec using our technology, you know, on our land or on some future place in Quebec, or whether that be the development programs we have underway with our engineering partners to define the turnkey plant that we will be licensing out to a variety of partners in jurisdictions all over the world. And that those two things will really kind of come together in 2024, we think.
Yeah,
it's gonna ultimately to drive expansion and growth.
Absolutely. It's going to be a pretty exciting one for sure. Dan, thanks so much for the update. Appreciate it. Congratulations on the success.
Thanks very much, Steve. Happy holidays to you.
Yeah, and you as well. Dan Blondal, the CEO of Nano One Materials Corp.